if you would. Have that information on your announcing card. If you do, fill out your announcing card and do not have it on there, please come see me, top of the tower. Left down main, ladies and gentlemen, from Sam Oregon, Mr. Randy Parker in Blazermania, a 427 cubic inch Chevrolet under the hood for Wayne Parker's Auto Electric. Double A, 4x modified category. 04 in the left main, Dave Lawrence from Hamburg. There at the 70-yard mark, see the smoke coming out, smoke rings on the top end. Safety crew going down to check out, it coast out the left lane.
Down. Down. Thank you. supposed to work for them, and would like to have them, but I don't pray so hard, and that Christian walk with God is so, well, it's so outstanding.
Yeah, I want to see it, don't you?
That sounds great on Skid Row.
Yeah.
Eric.
I can't handle that rock, sir. I enjoy that. Hey, that makes one, glad you couldn't dance, though. You don't do that, do you?
No.
I got my foot.
Fred, you and Willie are involved in, as people know, in a very, biblical ministry, and that is feeding the hungry. You're also giving them the gospel, that's what we're talking about. A little bit about all your giving us, but, yeah, giving that first, my Lord did that so often, standing on the hillside as he ministered, and he would give fruit. The Bible records a number of times, and we know that people hungry, that's where all the miracles took place, with the loaves of bread and the fish. You've got a wonderful role that we want to look at, and tell us about it before we get into it.
What's my role?
We're only willing. Willie, this is your moment.
This is my time.
We're not going to cut it.
Well, you know, we talk so often about the poor, about Skid Row, but to most people in America, they don't know what Skid Row is, and most people have never really seen poor people. We're so separated. You know, America is a nation of haves and have-nots, and the gap is widening. And so often, the other side of the tracks that people used to talk about, those who live on this side will see the other side. And so we just went down and Paul Crouch, our director, and he loves to wander the streets and Skid Row with that camera and just record what we see there every day. And so we brought this footage to let people see what poverty in America is really like.
All right, this is in Los Angeles?
Right here in Los Angeles.
Okay, let's watch this little roll-in with Greg, Willie George, and Paul Crouch to give us a little look at this.
Yes.
holidays, tomorrow, people will throw out more food at the end of the day.
I told him.
Why you put the empty camera?
To go any place.
What are you meaning?
I can't do anything.
And on the way home, when I was leaving, I stopped.
Shut up!
And he got into my car, and we drove probably 20 miles without saying, and told him what had happened. And in the...
Yeah, but it's not working, hun.
Feelings like betrayal, loss, anger, hate, and rolled them all into one. Despair, everything.
Move the fuck out of the way.
That might describe it.
Think of that.
No, it's not, Aaron.
No, put this thing.
Shut up, Aaron.
Was there any indication before? Because he told us he used to dress up and...
I knew that these things existed.
Mm-hmm. Had you ever seen him, had you ever come home and there he was dressed in your clothes?
Once,
yeah. And at the time, what goes through your mind? You know, it's amazing to hear talk about.
It's not on, Aaron. It's not recording anything.
Who made those vows in you. You're raised in a society that says you're going to grow up and you're going to have a white picket fence and
it's not trusted.
Yes, it is.
And a husband who loves you and comes home. Put your hand through here. That's how
I'm just trying to figure it out first.
Mm-hmm. You left him and Eugenia.
Unfortunately, this did happen. But fortunately, it has turned out well.
Yeah. When he raped your daughter, what was his reason? Did he say, was it because he was not, he didn't feel confident enough with you? He didn't feel man enough with you? Or this was going to make him feel more powerful? Or
I'm not quite sure. Mm-hmm. As he said in the previous tape, it was our anniversary. We had a very enjoyable evening out. All good times, he used to have to spoil them all.
Mm-hmm.
And you recall he said we fought all night.
Mm-hmm.
And along with this, apparently feelings of inadequacy.